During the spring 2020 UK lockdown due to coronavirus, we spoke with a group of Syrian refugees who are now living in the UK. We wanted to see if their experiences of coping through the adversities of the civil war in their homeland in any way prepared them for the difficulties we are all facing right now, and if so, what positives we might take from their shared reflections.
العالم نصدمي أيام من الأصوات المفزعة وأصوات الحرب يعني تعرف ما يا دوب الواحد يلحق يحمي أولاده يعني ما بفكروا لا بدراسي ولا شيء ساعات الوقت اللي بيكون في ضرب وحرب ما يعني يا دوب تحمي أولاده.
It's not easy to just keep your children away from the war, you know, it's very difficult because it's not like here, even in Syria, in Aleppo at that time, even if you are stay at home, you are not safe.
Little brothers, they're trying to calm them down and this stuff, but we can't see what's happening, you know, and we can't do anything.
You are in dangerous in any place. If you walk in the street or even if you are stay at home, if you are asleep in your home, you are not safe. In any time, maybe the rocket come and destroy everything.
Yeah. So my sister, she's got a daughter. She was 7 and she's got another son, like her son, it was around 4. And we got a new baby at that time. It was like a few months. So we had to teach them. It was heartbreaking for us to teach them. If you hear any bombing, to teach my niece, the girl, because she was the eldest, carry your young brother and run under the bed. That was heartbreaking to teach them to do that.
So at that time, we explained everything for the children because I thought this is the best way for them to know what happened.
ما يكون في ضرب في محلات كانت بسوريا مثلا محلات اكثر من محلات فيها ضرب ورصاص وهي ناخذ الاولاد نحميهم عند بيت جدهم مثلا او عند عمتهم يكون هنيك خفيف الضرب شوي.
I still remember many times there were multiple times where a bomb dropped right on in front of our eyes, and for because we are lucky, this didn't explode.
They tried to tell us it's okay, everything's gonna be fine, but at the same time we all scared.
وقت اللي روح اطلع على المشفى يكون في حواجز فاولادي يكونوا حطهم عند اهلي وروح على المشفى فيقولوا لي انه ما ترجعي فاضطر اولادي يبقوا صغار كانوا يبقوا عند اهلي وانا اضطر اني نام بمكان ثاني.
I remember many times 3 o'clock in the morning and when we hear the rockets and bullets and I thought at that time the building will drop. Will come down. So we wake up very quickly, have our important documents like passport and money and whatever. Yeah, and we stay in the corridor, sleep in the corridor, just waiting for any minute it will be fine to go and leave the house.
Like one time I were in my uncle's house, and his daughter, like she's 1 year old, she was like playing in her dolls. Okay, and suddenly we hear the shootout, and just like I grab her from the from her room because she had the window from the street. So I just like hold her to a safe place inside the house. And we just keep hiding until the shootout calmed down and. But we have no choice. We can't run. We can't go out. So, you know.
Because you want them to be safe. But that is the only way to teach them. If you hear any shooting in the street, you don't go out. You stay at home. If anything happens in the street, you hold your mom's hand. You don't leave her hand in any circumstances. You don't run away by yourself.
And that time it was in winter. So it was very difficult for me to look after my children and to look after my father and mother. my mother at that time, she had a cancer, and I should go and shopping for my parents and for my children. So yes, it was very difficult for me.
Yes, my big daughter, she's named Rahab. She said, I'm not gonna go back to my country. I'm scared.
In here, you just tell your kid, wash your hands, don't contact anyone. If you go outside, don't touch your face. That's it, it's simple and easy. In here, you don't see the enemy because it's just a virus. Back in Syria, the enemy is around you and everywhere. And you feel it, you hear it, you see it. It is a different experience.